गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज ऑर्थोग्राफिक प्रोजेक्शन, लैब एक्सरसाइज नंबर 9। ठीक है, वी विल स्टार्ट विद क्वेश्चन नंबर 1। इन ऑर्थोग्राफिक प्रोजेक्शन अ 3D फिगर विल बी गिवन टू अस, एज गिवन इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 1। यू कैन सी दिस फिगर, दिस इज अ 3D फिगर, एंड फ्रॉम दिस फिगर वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट इट्स फ्रंट व्यू, साइड व्यू एंड टॉप व्यू। ठीक है, नाउ रीड क्वेश्चन नंबर 1। Draw the front view, side view, top view of the following figure. This figure, 3D figure, we have to find out its front view, side view, and top view in first angle projection. If this first angle projection is given, if this first angle projection is given, then front view will be drawn above the reference line, top view below the reference line, and side view. It depends. If it's a right hand side view, then you can draw it on the left hand side of the front view. If it's a left hand side view, then you have to draw it on the right hand side of the front view. Clear? Now, next line, consider front view in the direction of A. Direction is given from the A. Suppose you are standing here at the position of A and you are looking at the figure. The view which is perceiving by your eyes, that is block C, block F and block G. So this is your front view. While looking at this figure, your eyes are perceiving this C, F and G block, which is front view. Clear? Then side view in the direction of B. So you can see B is written here on the right hand side. So this is your right hand side view. Clear? So this is your right hand side view, and from this view you can see block H, block B and block K. Again I am repeating, from the right hand side view, this is your right, on the right hand side, this is your right hand side. So you can see block H, block B and block K. Clear? So this is your right hand side view. Now we know we draw right hand side view on the left hand side of the front view in first angle projection. Next, and top view in the direction of C. So this is your top from the position of C. Now you are looking at the figure from the top side. Clear? So your view will be A, B and D. You can see these block only A, B and D. So this will be your top view. Here you have to know all the dimension. Take exact dimensions, and after completing the figure you can add your UID by editing the text. I hope this question is clear to you. Now we'll be moved to the software, how to draw it on the software. Now first of all, draw a horizontal line, a reference line of any length. And a vertical line to differentiate the front view and side view. Make sure that enough space is available on the left hand side, because we have to draw right hand side view, which will be drawn on the left hand side of the front view. Front view is here, then you have to draw a side view on the left hand side. Clear? So first of all, going back to this figure, we have to draw its front view from the position A, where we can see this block, block C, block F and block G. Clear? So calculate this horizontal dimension, 38 plus 28 and 18. This is 84. By adding these dimensions, this become 84 and height is 40. So first of all, we have to draw this rectangle of length 84 and width 40. So draw this rectangle. First of all, at any distance from the reference line, draw a rectangle of length 84. Height will be 40. Again, 80 on this side, sorry, 84 on this side, and downward 40. So this is the rectangle of height 40 and width 40 and length 84. Clear? So first of all we will draw this block C. From block C you can see this vertical height is 40 and this distance horizontal is 38. Clear? So this distance is 20 and this height is given here at distance of 20. So this is C, 20 is written here, so this is also 20. Clear? So we know all the dimensions and you can join these endpoints. So first of all, from this point you can go on the right hand side of distance 20, again take line. Now from this end on the right hand side 38 and vertical line is 20 and join it here at the mid end point of this line somewhere here. You can see with the end point joined here. So this is block C. You can see this is block C, which is our front view. Make it dark because it is the part of the drawing. This block C. Again, we will go back to the figure. Now we will draw this F block. This F block width is 28. You can see this length is 28 and height is 20. Here, width is 28, length is 28, and width is 20. This is 20, we know. We will extend this more, 28 downward 20. So this is block F and remaining block is G, which is 18. You can draw a line here from this point to this point. So this line, these lines are part of the drawing and make them 0.80. Increase the thickness to 0.80. The rest of the drawing is not a part of drawing. Again 0.05. Yeah. So this is the front view. If you want to write text here, you can use mText command. Using mText command, you can write here, this is block C, capital C. This is a block F, you can edit it, F, and this is a G. You can show dimensions also. Take linear dimensions. This should be 20. This should be 20. This should be 38. Again 28, sorry, and rest of line is 18. So thickness of these lines should be 0.05 because these are the dimension line. You can so also height of the block C, which is 40. This is 40. So this is the front view of that figure. Clear? Now we have to draw top view below this front view. because this is a first angle projection, so we will draw this front top view below the this front view. Clear? Now we have to draw its top view below this front view. First of all, draw projection line downward from all the corners. Draw projection line downward of any length. These are the projection lines from all the corners of the front view. You have to draw these projection line downward. You have to take every corner, draw these downward lines. And thickness of these lines should be 0.05, because these are only the projection lines. This should be thin line. Then take again line command. First of all, go back to this question. Now we have to draw its top view from the point C. We can see this block A and D and B. Yeah, A, B and D. We can see these blocks from the top. Length and width of the A is known. This total length is 50. This length is 50, and 50 is given here. You can see length of this line is 50, and this is 20. Yeah, so 20 into 50 is a block A and block B, and block B width is given 28 here. You can see this length is given 28. This we will calculate its length. Now for block D, this whole length 50, this 64, and starting from this point, this is up to the end point, it is joining with B here. So we will draw it like this. Now first of all, draw a rectangle. Draw a rectangle of width 50. This total width is 50 and this length is 84. First of all, draw this rectangle of 84 into 50. We know this length is 84 because we have drawn this on the for the front view, and we need a width of 50. This is 84. And this 50. What 50? This is key. We have drawn this rectangle 84 into 50. Now first of all, we will trim extra lines. We have to trim these extra lines, and we will draw front view of point A. Draw a line here up to this point. So this is a block A which were visible from top side. You can see this whole line will be part of the drawing. This is the 0.80, make it 0.80. This line up to from this point to this point, make it 0.80 also. So this is a block A which was visible from top. Another, we have to draw block B. We know height of block B is 28. Here 28, we can take from this side 28, and it was joined horizontally with this point, perpendicularly with this point. So this is the point B. This is the block B. This is the block B. You can join a line from this point to this point and make it dark. 0.80. The block P. This is the empty box, and we will extend this line to this point, perpendicular line up to this point, and join with this line here at this end point. We'll draw a line here. So this is the D. This line, and this line. This should be dark. And this is the point. We can draw another line from this point to this point and increase the thickness of these lines. Point 0.80. So these are the views of top view. Here, if you want to show it, you can write using mtext command. This block is block A. This block A. This block B. And this block T. And right here B. And block T here. Next command, this line should be thin because this is not a part of the drawing, and extend this vertical line also. These are the reference line. Now for the right hand side view, we have to draw right hand side view on the left hand side of the front view. So again we have to draw projection line on the left hand side of the front view. Draw this projection line of any length on the left hand side from every corner. We know thickness of these line is 0.05 because these are the projection line. Now, from the right hand side, by standing at position B, you can see this H, B and K. Dimension of H block is, this length is 50, this height is 20 here and 20 again here. You can see this is the rectangle of 50 into 40. This is the 50, 20, 15 to 20 of block H. And for the block P, we know this length is 28, which is joining with end line of 40. And the remaining is A. This is 28, 50 minus 28, it's 22. So this is 22 into 20. This is the block of K, 22 into 20. Clear? So we will draw this figure now, right hand side view. At any distance from this reference line, we will draw a rectangle of 50 into 40. 50 on the right hand side, 50, vertical 40, again 50, and downward 40. Press escape. I trim these extra line on the left hand side. I have to trim these lines here. These dimensions are 50. This height is 40. No need to give dimension on here because we are already given this 40. So this is same as 40 here. No need to give dimension to these line also, because this is at the distance of 20. We have shown here at the distance of 20. So this distance is seen from this point to this point. You have to draw a line here from this point to this point. Draw a line. This line is a dark. This all line should be dark here. This is the block H or block B. We know the length is 28. 28 on this side, on the right hand side, 28, and downward 20. Is K. So this is side view. Increase the thickness of this line 0.80 here. So we will calculate the distance. This distance is 28 as given in the figure, and remaining is 22 is for K. You can decrease the thickness. You can also give dimension to the top view also. Taking a linear dimensions, give this is 50, this should be 50. Any other distance? We have shown this length of this is 20 here. Yeah, no need to show any other dimension here. Using mText command. Using mText command, you can write the block H. Again, mText command B and K. You can write B and K, or you can simply copy this text right here. You can edit this text. Now, this is B block, block P, and this block is K. And so another distance here, because we have not shown this distance. So this is 20. All dimension lines should be thin 0.05. So this is the final figure. This is the final figure, and now by clicking double click on the dimensions, you have to add your UID. Suppose last two digit of UID are 61, then this should be 20.61. Clear? It should be 20.61. Like this, I did all the dimension. If 20 is written here, make it 20.61. 40 is written here, make it 40.61. again, this is 38.61, 28.61, 18.61, this is 50.61, 20.61, 28.61, 50.61. Here you have to add your UID. Suppose your last two digit of UID is 61, then make it 61. This is should be 18.61, 28.61. 38.61. This should be 40.61. 50.61. 28.61. Again, 20.61. 50.61. This is left 20, so make it 20.61. Yeah, and this figure is complete. So this is the front view, this is top view, and this is side view, right hand side view. You can write using mtext command also. Using mtext command, you can write here. This is the front view, this is the top view, and this is right hand side view. You can write here. So type here front view. This will be top view. This is right hand side view. Yes, I think this question is clear to you. So try it yourself now. If you have any doubt, you can write comment below this video. I will clarify all your doubts. Thank you very much.